nowadays it's a lot more present. The one great thing about social media is that it's so much easier to see men outwardly wearing makeup, or individuals are in a different spectrum or don't fall in a certain binary category. We have a lot more exposure to that. I'm still learning. There are words that I didn't realize that I could use to describe myself that I'm seeing now. Hey y'all, as I knock into that. Sorry. See that I always have to redo. Hey y'all, hey, I'm Mathieu Miranda, and welcome to another episode where I react to one of my former glory days of YouTube tutorialism. And I am joined by a very special guest and dear friend of mine, Brianna. Hi, Brianna. I actually am doing a little bit of a switcheroo. I had another video in mind to show you today to react to, but I had a special request from a fan of mine, which I thought would be kind of trippy, named Hanky Panda. In one of my previous videos, I think it was Party Girl Purples, I had asked if anybody had any special requests for other videos. And she described this video so well that it made it easy for me to figure out which video she was talking about.
Wait, is this the boob one?
No, nope. You're behind if you haven't seen that one. I want to read the comment that inspired me searching for this video so you can kind of know what you're getting into. Hanky Panda wrote, "If you ever come across that one video, red lips and black eyeliner, where you are under the weather and kind of loopy, please react." Oh, by the way, oh my God, I can't believe Brianna, I'm a horrible host. Because I'm just so comfortable with you, I didn't do what I normally do, which is introduce you and give you the opportunity to share how you and I met.
Okay, my name's Brianna. I usually go by Bree, and my pronouns are she, her. Matthew and I met when I first moved to Birmingham, Alabama. We both worked for MAC Cosmetics, and I specifically remember our first day of work together. Matthew was our resident trainer, and he happened to be visiting my counter that day. And there was some sort of drama involved with a phone, me answering a phone while I was helping customers. And I was so mortified because Matthew was our trainer, and I was, there was some kind of drama. And I think you were mad that I was, or not mad, but you like gave me some feedback that I shouldn't like answer the phone. I don't know.
I'm trying to remember the circumstance too.
I guess I wasn't answering the phone as well and giving the right service to a customer. Like, I wasn't giving ultimate customer service to the phone and the customer in the chair. That was our very first day together, and I was like, he's mean. So, but then after that, like, it was all good. We ended up being, like, roommates briefly, which was
under the radar. That was so much fun.
That
was not my most defining moment.
Do you remember it now? I don't even know what it was.
I don't remember the context. I do remember stressing you out, and I remember being stressed out. I can say I wasn't stressed out with you. I was stressed out with your manager, but I took it out on you, and that wasn't right to do.
Okay.
And now that I can speak as a free person, your manager was and is a dick. The video that we're going to watch together is actually the classic Bombshell video. And I think you'll appreciate this one because this is very much an on-brand Brie look. What do you think?
Oh, I think that sounds great. I love these videos.
This video was uploaded on September 26th, 2007. 13 years ago.
We met in 2013.
Wow.
Yeah. This was August.
August, so around your birthday.
Yeah, 2013.
This is the description. Actually, I'll let you read the description.
Please bear with me. I'm feeling really icky, so this didn't come out as cute as I was hoping. Haha. P.S. I'm aware I make weird noises. I don't know what's wrong with me. Could have been that pill I picked up off the bathroom floor and got high off of? Question mark. Most of the products I use are from MAC Cosmetics. They include, in order of appearance, Painterly Paint Pot. What is that? Getra blush? I've never heard of that.
After this video, you have homework too. I'm going to be doing your job survey form, and you'll be watching my 18-minute MAC collection video where Getra brush is revealed.
Mm-hmm. 224 brush, Brulee eyeshadow, Symmetry eyeshadow, Cork eyeshadow, 266 brush, Black Track fluid line, 306 brush, Mascara X. Man, I miss that. Dubonnet, Pure Vanity lip varnish. Recommendations, red or cherry lip liner, a neutral blusher. You called it blusher?
my friends from Ireland called it blusher, so I had to call it blusher.
X Plus and blot powder.
Oh my God.
Do I have to kiss my husband by?
Yes, of course. Go ahead.
You can edit that out, right?
Yeah. Or I can leave it in. Okay. Make it raunchy. Give me those hits.
Do you want me to? Thomas is pushing the camera close so we can't see.
Oh, shy guy.
No problem.
Hi, honey. Love you. Okay.
I love this so much.
This video, you have 35,000 views.
It has 111 likes and 23 dislikes at the very moment.
Oh, rude.
The more you know, the more you goals. Are you ready to jump into this low-quality attempt at teaching an audience how to create whatever my version of a classic bombshell look is?
So today we're going to be doing a classic bombshell look, which means neutral eyes and bold lippers. So let's go ahead and get started. Let me give a few shout-outs. To Lauren and England, hello. You have inspired me more than you ever know. And I just want to say that I think you're awesome. And the fact that you love the Golden Girls just as much as I do. It's like we were made for each other. And secondly, I want to say Kabuki. Hello, Miss Linda. You got me sick and I'm kind of mad at you for that, but I'll get over it. And then once again, I want to say hey to Elisa and Callie. And keep up the great work and keep in contact. All of you, every single one of you inspire me. And maybe next week I'll say your name because you inspire me too. Okay.
Why am I so sexual?
Right. The lip.
And I'm very virginal here, trust. I
need to find something else to use. And I actually have my brush belt with me instead of just random brushes.
Look! Isn't it pretty?
That's how you still talk to your cat.
You know we're using one of our Getra brushes!
That's a Getra brush.
Sick. I sure am playing a lot with my voice, and I shouldn't because it's my throat that's killing me. Starting from the upper lash line all the way underneath your eyebrow.
Look at you being fancy.
A lot
fancy.
Of people use their fingers to apply the base, and I don't see anything wrong with that.
Like I was bougie when it came to MAC. I did not want to apply anything.
Your eye quite a bit.
That's why, because I was told brushes will be better than wrinkles. Fingers. But then I'm over here in videos doing that.
Well, maybe they do. I don't know.
But painterly.
I don't.
Although when I do makeup,
I'm one of those bitches that has it all over my face.
But see, nowadays I much prefer to apply things with my fingertips. I feel it's much better. I've changed so much.
It warms it up a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm going to now put Brulee. I'm going to show you what that color is. It's this one right chalk.
Right chalk. I'm having to really pay attention to whose lips are moving, old Matthew or new Matthew, because
I've already applied
your voice still sounds foundation. Insane.
Oh, God.
I know you're probably thinking I'm faking being sick because I look so great, but the truth is, I'm a mess.
Oh, my God. I'm a trip. Oh!
Now I'm taking Symmetry, which is this color right here.
I guess it wasn't important enough for you to hear.
very full right now, but I have six other ones that are full, so.
This hair.
This one.
I love it. I think you should see that again.
Absolutely.
Really, any eyeshadow whatsoever. But homegirl is beat is all get out, okay?
Homegirl is beat.
And this nail polish that I have on is OPI.
Beat.
I think it's called Midnight at Moscow or Midnight in Moscow, but I don't know. I like it so much. It's a dark
black.
That is
the color, Midnight
Moscow.
With
some brown and red pigments to it. It's so pretty.
So you were kind of saying
and then
the
lastly, we're going to use Core.
Before everyone started using
this color.
It.
And we're going to put this.
It wasn't me. That was my colleague, Anthony. He taught me that word.
Excuse me. There's that smoker's cough.
You've never smoked a day in your life.
And if you do it, please stop.
Well, not at this point.
Oh, also, in the description, I talk about eating a pill I found off the floor and being high. If you didn't know me, I could see why people would be like, don't talk to her. But that was, I was just being silly. Good God.
Taking my ring finger.
There's that black track. You got There's, it.
Look, all you've got to do is just pull your entire eye to your temple and apply your eyeliner and expect it to look absolutely stunning afterwards.
Yes. I mean, it's looking pretty good, though.
I love how I go, see the difference? No,
okay, so
I don't.
Go all the way to the inner corner
you better.
Of your eye, but that tends to make your eyes look a little bit more dramatic. So that's why I'm stopping right where the lashes stop.
Why would I not want drama? I guess because I was thinking it's a singular focus feature of your lips.
Lord. Focus
My lashes
feature.
Seriously get in the way when I'm doing this.
Certification for
okay.
The perfect red
now
lip.
Oh my
on.
God. Do you remember which certifications of yours
bottom,
did I have
using
to do?
Just an eyeshadow.
I don't
think you did, because I was advanced.
I'm just gonna go from
one
the other
certified
corner.
When I moved to Alabama.
That's right.
And then I got advanced.
Some people choose to use a darker brown. Some people choose not to line their eyes at all on the bottom. I'm not gonna be putting any eyeliner in my waterline area.
You did certifications for somebody else at my counter, and I was there. Well, like, I was helping her.
Same brush, different stuff, and just pop it right.
That's so weird. I totally would have thought that you and I did an advanced certification or a prep or something.
I better hurry.
No, we helped like someone else do skill drills.
Mm-hmm.
Did you just make your eyes cross on purpose in there? I think you did.
Okay.
Did I? I'm not even watching. I'm
Ooh,
going back in my.
To my tongue being up.
Oh, this was back when
Better
YouTube didn't allow you to go past 10 minutes. So I was trying to do. Oh, I did.
Sorry, I was doing that to see if you were paying attention. Okay.
I was doing it to make sure you were paying attention, and you were. I wasn't. Past me
That's
just
right.
read future me. Out!
Right?
I've learned that if you lean your head back, this is a trick I learned from Lauren, if you lean your head back, you can get almost every single lash without snagging your eye, which is wonderful.
You are like one of the original
And you're less likely to
YouTube
get a mess up there.
Like, people didn't do makeup tutorials at this point, did they?
A few did, not many. It wasn't what it is now. Oh, I'm not going to line my lips for that. The whole look depends on it. That is, oh, wow. Brie, could you imagine? This was when I worked at Mac. I actually had people come to the counter and ask for my assistance when I looked like this.
Well, I love how this is a bombshell look. Like, but it's more
divinae.
Like, you need like a rest of bold red, right? For bombshell, or am I?
No, I'm using, sorry.
I think you're right.
Pure Vanity, which is a lip gloss. I don't know.
I don't like lip glosses
anymore. I know it's limited.
And yeah, I wish that your wings were a little more.
Like
did you do a wing?
I did a really bad
She thought she did. she made the motions. No. I want you to judge. That's what this is all about.
Okay, well...
So yeah, that's basically a
Let's see. Oh, hold on, wait.
A few minutes during the day.
I usually end it with something horrible.
Just make sure that your lips look nice, unlike mine. I'm not feeling too well today, so
They
I'm
look
about
nice,
to
but no
pimple. But anyway, thank you for joining me today. I hope you learned something new. Please make sure you email me at aboywearingmakeup if you have any questions, concerns, comments, compliments, or hate.
We're the-
Bye!
Did you just spread your legs like that? Like just, did you just... Was that what I saw?
I'm glad that's all you saw.
Okay, let's... Bree, this is going to be, hopefully, a dream of yours. I would like for you to put on the trainer hat, and I'd like for you to give 2007 Mathieu feedback. And if you would certify him, her, them, in whatever that was.
Where to start? Little bit about that lip. I noticed that you didn't choose to do a lip pencil with it. Why is that?
Because my client wasn't really feeling well and I wanted to eliminate an extra step and I was trying to think about saving her some money.
I noticed that in your description you recommended using red or cherry lip pencil. So don't you think that might have been important to show your client? Doesn't she need a lip pencil, even if she's tired?
You know what? I think you're right. I could have done that differently.
Yeah, like trying to use a red lipstick without a pencil, that's kind of hard because you're going to notice any mistake. You got to like fill in the gaps with your pencil.
But that lip line was like pretty legit considering I just did it from the bullet of the lipstick, right?
True. I mean, and you just, like, did one layer. It didn't even look like Duvernay. It looked almost berry color.
What can I say? I'm a one-hit wonder.
When it comes to that lip line application with a lipstick bullet.
I don't think I could have been a trainer. I was just almost as rude as you were about the phone.
Yeah, I was. I don't think you were being rude. I think you were impersonating me, and that sounded very on brand with how I was back then, for sure.
Sassy.
I think innately, I am a sassy person, and there are times when I'm self-aware. I know I'm being sassy. Those moments, believe it or not, I wasn't trying to be. I was trying to be more respectable, elevated. I was trying to challenge, but in healthy ways. But when I hear from my friends that worked at Mac, that are still my friends, and we talk about the dark years when I was a trainer, I certainly think I was a product of the type of feedback that I had been given. And then I, as much as I talked about how I didn't like that and I didn't want to become that, what did I do? I ended up being a mirror reflection of it. And it took me a long time, and it took a lot of really angry friends of mine to help me to realize that I can be helpful in this role and not be snarky. There were times when I would tell somebody that they did not get certified in a certain skill set, and they would cry, some of them. Those were the moments where I think the real me kind of shone through, because I would ask them, why are you crying? And they would say, because I failed. I said, no, you didn't. This is not a pass or fail situation.
Right.
This is just a certified now or not yet certified situation.
Right.
I remember being so shaky when my trainers would walk around and I'm trying to do the eyeliner and get the tear just right. And oh God, her eyes are not the same shape and size. And then you're trying to deconstruct it and be exactly what they want you to be. It's weird. This brand to me that represented so much individuality and creativity in those moments of structure and rigor, it trains your brain to be more aware of end result as opposed to the enjoyment getting there, which I think is what I miss about makeup. I miss just having that moment where I was like, okay, what am I feeling today? And instead, it was very much, use this brush, use this, tilt your head this way, you're going to do that. It's all great tips and tricks. But then when you start focusing on it when somebody else is doing it and you're asked to give them feedback to get them to be better, now you start taking the fun out and it becomes a checklist of, you didn't do this, you didn't do this, you could have done this better. And it sucks. It shouldn't be that way. I shouldn't have been that way.
So, from the perspective of getting certified, to this day, I am still proud of getting advanced and advanced 2 certified because of how hard it was. Like, it's almost like not good. I mean, it was so hard, but it was so satisfying when you finally passed. And knowing just how difficult it was and how precise it needed to be. So from that, like from just certification perspective, I really, I don't know, I thought it was cool. I still sometimes like tell people about the customers about it.
Yeah.
Special eyeliner. But the other thing that you were talking about where you sort of try and emulate people when they're telling you how to give certain feedback and you're kind of doing it the way that they say and you're not being yourself, like that's, and it comes off like not natural and kind of snarky or whatever. I experienced that because it's like people told me how to get, people gave me feedback on giving feedback and it just wasn't natural and I felt like I was being a bitch.
Do you mind if we read a few comments together?
I would love that.
Okay, some of them are mean, so I want to prepare you for that. I'm okay with that. I think they're even better. It's like reading a mean tweet. You know how some celebrities do that? So usually what I try to do is I try to like them, and then I'll write back. So let's see what we've got.
Thanks for the shout out. You are my bestest friendest in the wide worldest, LOL. Golden Girls kick butt, great videos. You cracked me up with laughter. You were so funny. Zoom, zoom.
Zoom, zoom.
What does zoom, zoom mean?
I think that means goodbye, take care. I think that was something she used to type out a lot at the end of videos. That's funny. That's what we're using to do this now.
Oh my gosh, you scared the living mess out of me when you made the little smoker. What? Mobidity? What? Can you see that? I'm having to look closely. Mobidity?
That little smoker. What are they talking about?
Mobibidity? What is that?
We're going to skip this one. Oh, look at this. Ooh, you are really good at makeup. Don't you get a lot of hate mail and crap? All of your comments are positive. How cool.
It's like that person wanted to come to your profile and see hate mail.
That's so
You're so handsome without and with makeup.
Oh, that was sweet.
That is. Look at all these comments. These are so nice. But I know you said there are some bad ones.
But I haven't seen any yet.
I haven't either. OMG, wow, I love you because I'm a boy, but I have a passion for doing and wearing makeup. Plus, I'm 16, so some people say I'm a little weird, but I think it's cool. And also, you remind me of Chris Crocker in a nice way. That's precious. Not, I mean, the Chris Crocker thing. I'm talking about the, like, he's 16 and...
I wonder where he is now.
He's weird. That's really, really
sweet. I'm going to reach out to him right now. Reaching out to you.
Yes.
2021. How are you doing?
I love that so much. You know, I wonder, Matthew, like how many little boys who were walking in the store that you inspired when you were working at counter, honestly, because it's so often that boys come up to the counter and they're with their moms and they're so interested in the colors because who wouldn't be? It's all these beautiful colors and their mom's like, stop it, that's for girls. But like, I wonder how many little boys they saw you and that you inspired them. I bet that happened all the time, honestly.
Yeah, I remember hearing that too. It was weird to hear a mother tell their kid that this is for girls when I'm standing right there in front of them.
What did you say? Did they like put two and two together when they...
Sometimes I think the classic line would be like, oh, you know what I meant, right? I didn't mean anything offensively.
No, I didn't know what you meant.
Yeah, no. Right. I know. Sometimes I probably did say that. I'm like, no, what did you mean? What did you mean? But then I think sometimes I would say makeup is for everybody. There was a lot of years where it felt as if I was a zoo animal and that I was just always on display. And so I turned it around. I wanted you to look at me because you were going to look at me anyway. Now I'm giving you something really to talk about. And I wanted to sort of reflect what I was feeling. And I think when the kids would come and ask me, and I could tell that they were genuinely just curious, mm-hmm. it was such a wonderful moment because I got to lean down and ask them if they wanted to put on a little bit of makeup, and if their parents said it was okay, then that became a whole moment, and I loved that. But you know, there were definitely times when parents would shuffle their kids out or didn't want them to say anything, or would just, you know, they wanted the transaction, they wanted to get their lipstick and not hear about the recycling program and go about their business, you know. Nowadays it's a lot more present. The one great thing about social media is that it's so much easier to see men outwardly wearing makeup, or individuals are in a different spectrum or don't fall in a certain binary category. We have a lot more exposure to that. I'm still learning. There are words that I didn't realize that I could use to describe myself that I'm seeing now. So I definitely think that it is truly, we have come a long way, but I do think what's helping me is seeing the verbiage that I'm using and the mannerisms that I take and what I talk about. And I realize that when we think about equality for all, I was the one not treated as an equal, but my words and my actions also show that I have an opportunity to look at others with a clean slate and to not be judgmental and have a preconceived notion based on color, status, wealth, height, weight, whatever.
Yeah, so that makes sense.
I like that these videos are allowing me that opportunity now in a way that I wouldn't have seen just doing them before. Thank you so much for checking out today's episode on my channel. I hope that you enjoyed. If you like this type of content, make sure that you stay subscribed to my channel. Hit that notification bell. If you didn't like this, as I mentioned in my past video, just spread your legs and send it to your enemy. Any press is good press, if you ask me. Did you want to tell my viewers anything to keep up with you or your Instagram, all that stuff? Take it away.
My Instagram isn't super, like, interesting, but my cats have an Instagram, and if you would like to follow it, they are called the Gray Kitty Committee, and their Instagram is the_gray, spelled with an E and not an A, _committee. And we just today added a new member to the committee. We now have 4 cats. We're crazy cat people. But anyway, I would definitely recommend following them because it's really fun. Oh yeah, all of our cats are named after country music singers.
Okay, can you please tell my viewers your cat's names?
So there's Loretta Lynn, and then there's Emmy Lou Harris, and she goes by Emmy or Lulu. And then we have Margot Price, which is like a newer kind of country singer right now. And our 4th one, we're currently calling Voldemort. She must not be named, or he must not be named, because we don't yet know her name. So we're thinking of like Patsy Cline, Reba McEntire, or Dolly Parton. Her name right now is Missy Poo. That was her name when we adopted her, Missy Poo. So I kind of want to name her Miss Dolly, like Miss Dolly Parton.
Miss Dolly. I know, when you said Dolly, I was kind of leaning towards that. My vote is for Miss Dolly. I love it, the Great Kitty Committee.
Yeah.
Brianna, Bree, excuse me. I'm so used to calling you Brianna. Because it's not Brianna, it's Brianna.
Yes, Brianna.
And I learned that very early on. Have a wonderful day or night. Make good choices. And until next time, I will see you soon.
Bye.
You can wave too. I'll put a frame up of you waving.
You can make my love.